Hello and welcome to my tutorial on how to use the Plastisol toolkit for Photoshop. Okay, let's start off by going over each section. The main texture effects, and there are 20 of them, are all contained in a folder called Main Plastisol Effects. Each effect has its own set of folders, but the most important thing is the Smart Object. That's the place where you'll add in your own artwork. Each effect has a background colour that you can change dynamically, and an extra texture layer. The extra texture layer is handy if you don't want a completely flat background colour, as it carries the main texture into the background. You can change its opacity or turn it off altogether. Okay, time to add in some of our own artwork. Let me find a texture that I like. Let's see. Ooh, I like this one. Let's use this one. As you can see, it has a large amount of distortion and lots of chips where Plastisol was cracked off. When you are ready to edit, just double click the Smart Object to open it in a new window. So in this case, I'm going to add artwork that I've already created from Illustrator. So let's hop into Illustrator. This is some artwork that I created on my iPad, but you can use artwork from anywhere. Any vector, bitmap, it doesn't matter. As long as you can put it in Photoshop, you can use it. Let's just select all and copy. Let's jump back into Photoshop and paste in the design. You can choose Smart Object or Pixels. I'm going to select Pixels. If your artwork is small, you might be better pasting it in as a Smart Object. That way you can scale it without losing quality. Now I can get rid of that original piece of artwork that was there because I just don't need it. Position this more centrally. Now, I think that colour might be too much, so I'm going to change these words to white. I'm going to lock the transparency of that layer, select around these words, fill it with white. Edit, fill, OK. Right, I'm happy with that. All I need to do now is save and close. As you can see, the artwork immediately has the cracked effect applied to it. All done with a layer mask. The layer mask, by the way, is here. So if you want to see what your artwork looks like without it, you can disable it. Okay, that's looking good, but let's try out the Plastisol edge effects. You go to Window Actions, you should see the 5 actions that we can use as part of this kit. Okay, here I'm running the light edge effect. Can see it's looking good, it's looking distorted. There are a few areas that I'm not happy with, so you can see here it's created a layer mask. I'm just going to go into the layer mask and clear off a few of these dark black areas. It's boring watching people paint, so I'm going to speed this bit up. Okay, so we come out of the layer mask and we can apply that layer mask. Put the texture layer back on. Now we have the exact same logo, or the exact same lettering, but with edge distress. Now we've covered the edge distress, let's move on to the brushes. After you've installed the brushes, you'll see 15 new presets. All of them are different, so it's a case of just picking one and experimenting with it. But first you'll need to add a layer mask to your artwork. I've already got a layer mask, so let's just go in here, scale it down. And you can either click once or click twice for a bolder effect. Again, I'm going to speed up this process because it's pretty boring to watch. And that's it. I hope you enjoyed watching this tutorial. And as they say in London, hey, laddie.